public opinion and the entire British political establishment have rounded on News International. Tomorrow, Rupert Murdoch, his son James, and Rebecca Brooks, who until Friday was considered almost family, will have to face the music before a House of Commons committee.
That means most prime ministers have conducted their dialogue with Murdoch from their knees.
Dear Mr. Murdoch, what have you done with your news of the screws and your sore away son? You sharpen our hatred, you've blunted our minds. We're drowning in nipples and bingo and sex crimes. How many times must they poke and they pry? Must they twist and lie? Just to add to the grime, they even screwed up the times, left to kick their ass goodbye. Oh, wouldn't I? Dear Mr. Murdoch, you play hard to see, but with your bare ass cheek, you should be on page 3. Dear Mr. Murdoch, really the pits. Bad news is good business, you're the king of the tits. They stain all they touch, they're real woman haters. But we're on the trail. They go straight for the lowest common denominators. How could they fail? Go straight to jail,
no bail.
Mr. Murdoch, you're a powerful man. You control half our media, whose lifeblood is scam. Dear Mr. Murdoch, not so amused. Just line up the people whose lives they've abused. From getting so hard to tell if you're a Yank or a punk.